Hey everyone. I just want to address something that I think is kind of a misconception among a lot of consumers out there. I'm going to just try to give it to you straight about these. And please don't misunderstand, I'm not disparaging these products in any way, but I think people just need to have a more realistic expectation of what they do and what they're capable of. So I just recently went through a 2-day power outage here in the central coast of California. And so I was relying on my battery packs. The one on the right, the BlueEti, is mine. This one I borrowed from a friend. It's the new Anker Silix C1000. And these are very, very handy to have in a power outage. And this one, the Anker actually powered my full-size refrigerator for about 7 hours, which I was actually pretty impressed with. But I think it's important to understand the limitations of these, and also too how you're using them. So the first thing is these are really invaluable for charging electronics. Cell phones, laptops, computers, floor lamps. I mean, you can even run a TV and a router off them. They can help keep you online and in communication with friends and family. They're very handy from that standpoint. The most efficient use of them is with small electronics. So I would put cell phones, tablets, laptops, also, like I said, routers, those sort of things in that category. They're least efficient with any kind of cooking appliances like coffee makers, hot water kettles, toaster ovens, anything like that. Those are major, major consumers of power. Which is why, in some of the emergency prep meetings and workshops I've held, I actually recommend using either propane or butane for cooking, and kind of advise against using electrical power for heating up food in emergency situations. It's just, frankly, not a very efficient use of what's essentially a finite resource in an emergency situation. So the big panel over there, this is BlueEti. Those are some solar panels. That's a quad fold thing. So basically they fold out. I'll add the picture of it folded out in the video so you'll see what it looks like. So this gets back to kind of the marketing of these. And again, I want to tread carefully. I have a high opinion of both Anker and BlueEti and the products they're developing. But in the marketing of these products, they sometimes call these generators. And frankly, the only thing that makes them generators are the solar panels. Otherwise, these are battery packs. So you charge them up from a wall outlet when you still have power, and then you use the banked power as you need in a power outage situation. So the only way these are generators is if you get the accessory solar panels. And also too, the power production of the solar panels is dependent on the brightness of the sun, cloud cover. Although I will say this, the input power from this with fairly direct sunlight was 170 watts out of a rated 200 watts maximum output. So I thought that was actually pretty good. But it will take a few hours. And again, that also is dependent on the size of your solar array and the size of your battery pack. So for instance, that's a 200 watt array. The BlueEti, that's the EB70S, which has since been discontinued, but I think that's 768 watt hour capacity, I believe. The Anker is a little bit over 1,000 kilowatts, or basically 1 kilowatt hour. So that would take several hours. I absolutely recommend having one of these if you live in an area that's prone to power outages, or you like going camping or doing recreational activities, where it would be handy to have portable power. But just understand the limitations. Understand they're not a replacement for a whole home. Now, they do make systems that can support a whole home, energy usage scenario. Basically, effectively, almost like a replacement for or an equivalent of a Tesla Powerwall. So some of these, not this one, but they have other models that are modular, where you can add on additional packs up to, gosh, like 20 or 40 kilowatt hours, which is pretty substantial. These are just, again, small electronics. I did run my fridge on this for 7 hours, which, considering its size and weight, I was really impressed with, actually. They do make a bigger model. Anchor Solix actually has multiple models, from even smaller than this to like triple the size. So just be aware of what your needs are. Have realistic expectations in an outage scenario. Don't expect you're just going to live life like normal. And if you are, be willing to pay for it. I mean, I would say at that point, if you want zero disruption in your lifestyle, in the middle of a power outage, consider getting a full-fledged home solar system or a Tesla Powerwall, or one of the larger systems like this, where you can stack multiple battery packs. Again, I have great respect for both of these companies and respect for the technology. And in some ways, I think it's better than gas or combustion generators. In some ways, it's worse. We're not quite at price parity with gas generators in terms of power output, but it's getting there. These are coming down in price, and these are nice if you live in an apartment or, I personally, I live in a condo association where they don't allow gas generators, so this is really kind of my only choice. But I recommend them. I think they're great, but just don't ask too much of them. Just use them smart, use them sparingly. If you don't have a means of recharging them, either through a solar panel or a wall outlet, or sometimes you can charge them through like the 12 volt outlet in your car. If you don't have a means to recharge them, just treat them like a finite resource, which is effectively what they are for the time of the outage. If you can afford it, I would recommend having the solar panels as a backup way to power them in an extended outage scenario. It just seems there's a lot of misconceptions out there about what they're capable of, how to use them, what they can do, and what they can't do. So, anyway, if you have any experiences or questions, just leave a question in the comments and I'll try to answer what I can. But I hope this kind of puts these in a little more rational context than sometimes they're presented as. So hope that helps you guys out.